Treyarch has a very good track record with the Black Ops franchise, but that doesn't mean that it's perfect. Welcome to the page, everybody. Jimmy or Chaos. Today, we're going to be checking out the 5 Black Ops games in the franchise and the most bugged out weapons that have ever been put in them. Those guns that either had a bug, a glitch, an aimbot, you name it, something that broke the matrix in the Black Ops game. So you guys let me know, give me a good guess which one you think is going to be number one today, and let's just jump right into it. At number 10, the SVUAS in Black Ops 2. I've called this sniper underrated a few times on the channel, and I stand by it. However, some of you encountered this frustrating glitch a few times while going for that gold camo grind back in the day. Nobody knows exactly why, but when using the SVUAS, there's a small chance that your bullet will just go through your target without even hitting them, a la the Matrix. Like I said, essentially making the gun useless for that shot. It was very rare that this happened, and nobody really knew how, and nobody knew when they pulled the trigger if it was going to happen. It was a very small chance, but it seemed every time you pulled the trigger on the SVU, there was that very small chance you would get a ghost bullet. Now, some people think this is due to programming error in the SVU, while others think it's actually an issue with the character models in Black Ops 2, although that wouldn't really explain why the SVU is the only gun that had ghost bullets. Regardless, if you felt like you were shooting right through people with the SVU back in the day, maybe you weren't crazy. The gun was actually bugged. At number 9, the RK5 in Black Ops 3. Another case of ghost bullets. Much like the SVU, the RK5 pistol in Black Ops 3 had a chance to fire a non-existent bullet. It was very rare, not many people experienced it, but there is footage of it actually happening. The RK5 was a 3-round burst pistol, but have you ever noticed? Sometimes you pulled the trigger, only 2 bullets would come out despite 3 shots being taken from your ammo count. There actually was a bug in Black Ops 3 that caused a slight chance for 1 bullet to get deleted when you pulled the trigger on the RK5. Making it a 2-round burst despite still taking 3 bullets out of your inventory. That's not very fair, I know. Definitely a weird bug, but thankfully it was rare enough that it wasn't a huge problem. At number 8 today, the SPAS 12 with the suppressor in Black Ops 1. Now, the SPAS 12 was one of my favorite guns in the original Black Ops. It wasn't as powerful as the Modern Warfare 2 version, obviously, but it was still good and it was pretty devastating on smaller maps. But there was a suppressor bug with it. That's right. It was actually bugged on the shotgun. Normally, suppressors in COD will keep you from appearing on the mini-map at the cost of decreased range, but the SPAS 12 suppressor was actually bugged in a beneficial way to you and me. It still kept you from appearing on the enemy's radar when you pulled the trigger, but it also did not decrease your range, meaning there was zero penalty at all for using it. So if you were using the SPAS without a suppressor back in the day, you messed up because there was literally no reason not to put the suppressor on the shotgun. At number 7, the Akimbo Blueprints in Black Ops Cold War. This one may have been fixed by now, but you may have noticed it. There's a lot of weapon blueprints in Black Ops Cold War, and they're only supposed to be aesthetic changes, but did you know they can actually screw with the kill feed? If you're running an Akimbo pistol blueprint, any pistol in Black Ops Cold War, your kills will always show up in the kill feed as being from the 1911. Now, this one may have been fixed, like I said, I'm not sure, but I know for a while, the Akimbo Blueprint pistols always showed up in the kill feed as that classic 1911, despite coming from other weapons. Probably just a little programming oversight when adding new blueprints to the game, but now you know. In the grand scheme of things, it could have probably been a lot worse, and it's actually kind of a cool little Easter egg bug thingy. Maybe somebody put it in there on purpose. At number 6. The MSMC with MMS sight in Black Ops 2. That's a lot of M's. MSMC, MMS. This one has been patched, so don't go try it today and then come back and call me a liar because it won't work. But when Black Ops 2 first came out, there was a bug with the MSMC submachine gun and the MMS optic. If you don't know, that optic would scan through walls while you were aiming down the sights. It would give you a little look at where enemies were, but it would be countered by cold-blooded. It would also scan through smoke. If you're using the MMS on the MSC, you could still see cold-blooded users for some reason. Treyarch patched this one pretty quick, and not many people actually noticed it before it was fixed, but those that were astute and eagle-eyed, they knew it, and they knew how to abuse it, because the combo essentially gave you free wall hacks. At number 5, the Stakeout with the Grip in Black Ops 1. I loved the Stakeout. It was the one and only pump-action shotty back in the original Black Ops. It was super fun to run around with on Nuketown. The only downside of the weapon had a very, very, it was low rate of fire. It was super low. 63 rounds per minute. Now, that's roughly one shot per second. Yeah, we did math. However, there was a bug where you put the grip attachment on it. It not only reduced the recoil, but it also sped up the fire rate to about 71 rounds per minute, which that doesn't sound like a lot on paper, I know, but for a pump action weapon, it was a noticeable increase. If you were running the stakeout and you had to run it with the grip because it was an all-round buff, you really did. I mean, there was no reason not to use it. Just like we talked about the silencer before on the Spaz, you needed to have the grip on the stakeout in Black Ops 1 or you weren't taking advantage. At number four, the Akimbo TAC 45s in Black Ops 4. Now, the TAC was a super powerful pistol. It was boring looking, it was regular, but it was hiding a monster. It looked, sounded basic, but it had a two-shot kill potential that made it extremely powerful and easy to exploit. But there was also a bug with the audio that made it a little weird. Not a lot of people noticed it. If you ran the TAC in akimbo mode, the firing sound actually changed to the 5.7 firing sound. Now, if you were running it in single form, the TAC 45 and 5.7 obviously have different firing sounds. But if you ran the TAC 45 in akimbo, the firing sound magically changed to the 5.7s. Despite how many patches Black Ops 2 got back in the day, this bug was never fixed, probably because not many people actually ever, honestly, noticed it. At number three, the TAC 45 with the TAC knife in Black Ops 2. It was a pretty buggy weapon, actually, when you look back at it, although this one was a little less obvious than the akimbo bug. If you ran the TAC 45 with a tactical knife, you actually had a different recoil pattern. Now, by default, the TAC 45 had some bouncy recoil. A little side to side, but if you're using the tactical knife, the recoil went almost all vertical, making it a lot easier to hit your follow-up shots. I also swear, the reload on the TAC knife version was slightly slower than the standard TAC 45, but that could have been a design by choice as opposed to a bug. Regardless, the TAC 45 got a new recoil pattern when using the TAC knife, which I think that's pretty interesting and very obviously not intentional. At number two today, the Street Sweeper with the flashbang in Black Ops Cold War. You guys remember a few months ago when absolutely everybody was doing this? When the Street Sweeper shotgun was introduced, this glitch actually plagued Cold War's multiplayer because of how easy it was to do and how busted it was in hardcore modes. By running the Gung-Ho perk with the Street Sweeper and flashbangs, you could hold a flashbang in one hand and still fire the Street Sweeper in the other. Doesn't sound like much, but the main appeal was the fact that it completely canceled your sprint out time, meaning you could fire the shotgun immediately after coming out of a sprint. It also meant that when somebody killed you, your character would drop the flashbang. It would explode and hit the person who killed you, and most likely they got killed as well, giving you an assist, kind of like a martyrdom. The community was split on whether this was a glitch or just an exploit, but I believe it's been patched now, so it's clear that Treyarch never intended it to be there. Regardless of what label you want to put on it, the Street Sweeper flashbang thing was super annoying, and it pushed a lot of people away from hardcore game modes until it got fixed. And finally, at number one today, the most bugged out, glitched out weapon in the Black Ops franchise has to be the every attachment glitch in Black Ops 1. If you played a lot of Black Ops 1 back in the day, you might remember this, but it was rare. Nobody knows why. But every once in a while in the original Black Ops, you would have come across a gun on the ground with every single attachment on it at once. Seriously. I mean, the maximum number of attachments on a single gun in this game was two. So it was pretty weird how every once in a while, you would come across a gun on the floor that had every attachment. You couldn't pick it up. There wasn't any gameplay of using it. Nobody knows why this glitch actually happened or how it was triggered, but I'm sure at least a couple of you remember the every attachment glitch back in the original Black Ops, and it was a massive one. So I gave it the number one spot today. It's a little kind of lore piece of Call of Duty history. If you didn't know about it, go look it up. And there you have it, my friends. Those are the most bugged out weapons in the Black Ops franchise. I already have the video getting ready to go for the most bugged out weapons in the Modern Warfare franchise. If you guys want to see it, so show some love on this one. Make sure you're subscribed with those notifications completely turned on. Thank you for all the support. If you made it to the end of the video, I appreciate you. I truly, truly do. I'll see you guys on the next one.